Hello everyone, myself Dr. Himani Patel. Welcome to Shri Swaminarayan Physiotherapy College YouTube channel. Today we are going to explore about the screw home mechanism in knee joint. Before switch towards our topic, to get latest updates, press the bell icon, like and subscribe our YouTube channel. Knee joint. Knee is the largest and more complex joint in human body. It is a compound synovial type joint. The surround ligamentous and numerous muscle attachments provides a better complexity to knee joint. Knee joint role in mobility as well as stability. So knee joint is made up of basically tibiofemoral joint and the patellofemoral joint. The tibiofemoral joint is the articulation between distal femur and the proximal tibia. And the patellofemoral is the articulation between the posterior patella and the femur. Now, what is screw home mechanism? So, screw home mechanism occurs in non-weight bearing position and in weight bearing position also. So, in non-weight bearing position, when we sit and do the flexion extension of knee joint, that time the tibia is free to move on femoral condyle. And in weight bearing position, when the foot planted on the ground and we do the squatting, that time the femoral condyles move on tibial condyle. See, the first picture shows the non-weight bearing position. So in left side, you can clearly see the tibial condyle move on fixed femoral condyle. And in second picture, right side, the femoral condyle moves on the fixed tibial condyle. So this is a weight bearing position. Hello everyone. Now we'll see screw home mechanism in non-weight bearing position and in weight bearing position. So as I explained earlierly, in non-weight bearing position, tibia is free to move and femur is in fixed position. So as we know that the medial tibial condyle have larger articular surface than the lateral condyle. Similarly, in femoral, medial femoral condyle have a larger articular surface than the lateral condyle. So what happened? In non-weight bearing position, tibia is free to move and femur is in fixed position. So in last 30 degree of the knee extension, tibia anteriorly move on femoral condyle. So as per convex rule, tibia will complete rolling and gliding anteriorly in same direction. So in last 30 degree of knee extension, the tibia will complete rolling and gliding anteriorly, and now in 25 degree of the knee extension, the lateral condyle completes its rolling and gliding. It is act like a pivot, and medial condyle left over articular surface, because medial condyle have larger articular surface. So medial condyle anteriorly completes its rolling and gliding and laterally rotates on fixed pivot. So this is known as, this lateral rotation is known as automatic rotation or terminal rotation or locking of the knee. So it is like a screw, act like a screw. So we can say that screw home mechanism. See the beauty, I'm exaggerating for, so you can understand easily. See the beauty. So in this position, all the surrounding structures are in locked position. Knee will not unlock in this position. So this is completely locked position, locking of the knee. Quadriceps, femoris muscle are responsible for locking of the knee. So now unlocking of the knee, unlocking. So here what happened? Exactly opposite. So medial rotation of the tibial condyle and flexion will continue. So medial rotation of tibial condyle on femoral condyle and flexion will continue. So this is unlocking. So this is all about in non-weight bearing position, Now we see in weight bearing position. So as I explained earlier, when we stand and doing this squatting, that time tibia is in fixed, foot planted on the ground, and femoral condyle completes its rolling and gliding on tibial condyle. So as per convex rule, so femoral condyle rolling and gliding in opposite direction. So here last 30 degree of the knee extension, remember, in last 30 degree of knee extension, the femoral condyle should be roll and gliding in opposite direction, rolling in anterior and gliding in posterior direction along with the medial rotation of the femur. So this is locked position, see, like a screw. So screw home mechanism in weight bearing position. Now for the unlocking, first lateral rotation occur, then the flexion can proceed. So this is unlocking of knee in weight bearing position. So remember, in weight bearing position, in non-weight bearing position, there is exactly opposite direction occur. Now we see the theoretical part, automatic or locking mechanism of the knee. So there is obligatory lateral rotation of the tibia that accompanies the final stages of the knee extension. This coupled motion is referred to as automatic or terminal rotation. So as I explained practically, in the last 30 degree of the knee extension, the shorter tibial plateau and femoral condyle pair completes its rolling and gliding motion before the larger medial articular surfaces do. So as extension continue in non-weight bearing position, remember, in non-weight bearing position, the longer medial plateau continues the roll and glide anteriorly after the lateral side of the plateau has halted, means lateral tibial condyle act as a pivot. Now this continued anterior motion of the medial tibial condyle results in the lateral rotation of the tibia on the femur, with the motion most evident in final 5 degree of extension. So this is also known as the locking or screw home mechanism. To initiate knee flexion, the knee first must be unlocked. That is, laterally rotated tibia must medially rotate along with the flexion is initiated. A flexion force will automatically results in medial rotation of the tibia, because the longer medial side will move before the shorter lateral compartment. So this is all about in non-weight bearing position. So here quadriceps femoris muscle responsible for the locking of the knee. And for unlocking, study shows popliteus muscle is responsible. So this picture is on femoral on tibial extension, meaning weight bearing position, the rolling and gliding should be in opposite direction as per concave convex rule. So now we'll see in weight bearing position. So this automatic rotation occurs in both the weight bearing and non-weight bearing knee joint function. So in weight bearing, the freely moving femur medially rotates on the relatively fixed tibia during the last 30 degree of knee extension. So here, in last 30 degree of knee extension, tibia is fixed and femur is medially rotate on fixed tibia. So same as unlocking is consequently brought about lateral rotation on femur on the tibia before flexion can proceed. So same as in non-weight bearing position, but exactly opposite movements occur. So this is all about weight bearing and non-weight bearing, how screw home mechanism occurs. These all are my references. Thank you.